The first time Nellie McClung saw the premier about votes for women...
Things are changing. Good day, sir.
It didn't go too well for McClung.
Take it from me, Mrs. McClung. Nice women.
Become the first in Canada to get the provincial vote. And now the fight is over, at least in the Western world. My next guest says feminism is done. Gavin McInnes is a writer with StreetCarnage.com, joins us from New York. Now, Gavin, you've written this latest article. It's called Catfight. So I'm going to ask you a few questions about it. This isn't the first time you've written about feminism. Let me start by asking you, because you upset a lot of feminists in this world, why do you hate women so much?
I hate women because they're not attracted to me anymore now that I'm ugly. So I search the internet for statistics to justify some sort of attack on them because it makes me feel better about myself.
Okay, so you say feminism is dead. You've gone on in this article to say feminism can't complain about real suffering anymore, so they create straw men to rail against. What do you mean there?
Yeah.
What kind of straw men are these women creating?
Well, for example, I was defending Terry Richardson because he's a photographer who slept with this woman who was like a porn star, pinup girl, whatever. And several years later, she decided she didn't enjoy the intercourse and criticized him. I defended him saying, sorry, that's not rape. You're trivializing rape. And then I was called a rape apologist. So they take a statement like, I find women can be annoying when they're drunk. And then they change that into... Women should not be allowed in bars.
Right.
And you go, I never said that.
Well, you know, I don't identify with the feminist movement so much because I think there's such a negative stigma attached to that word. But let me play the devil's advocate for a second. You know, women will come at you and they'll say, we still get catcalled on in the street. There are still some statistics that show that women make less than men. This is a movement that is ultimately about empowering women. You know, how do you respond to that?
I say, I'm not counting Islam or anything east of Europe. I'm saying today in the Western world, 2014, the crusade is done. Women don't earn less than men. Women choose to earn less than men when they're married and have kids because they'd rather go to their daughter's piano recital than stay up all night working on a proposal. When women are single and young, they actually make more than men. And as far as catcalling goes, working class women, black and Hispanic women, enjoy catcalling. Middle-class liberals hate it, but I'll tell you, the only thing women hate more than catcalling, even white middle-class liberals, is the day it ceases.
I hate catcalling, but I still get catcalled. Now,
come
I want to pull up a full... I want to pull
come
up a
on,
few...
Come on, you really hate it? Hey, beautiful woman, I find you attractive. How is that annoying?
Well,
hey, woman who spent some time getting ready this morning to look pretty. You did it. It worked.
Okay, fine. But let me pull up a few boards from men, actually, that have responded to your article. Because, you know, the first thing that came to my mind is none of them are wearing a wedding ring. So this one says, I'm a happy feminist because feminism empowers me. The second one says, I'm a happy feminist because not all men are jerks like Gavin McInnes. I guess that's you. The third one says, I'm a happy feminist because I get to be an aspiring ally and work with amazing people. And the fourth says, I'm a happy feminist because I can wear what I want. You know, again, I got to go back to this point. None of them are wearing wedding rings. Let me know if you think that matters. And the second point is, I think they missed the point.
Well, that's how bad it's gotten. Now, it's feminism has become so loose and so diluted that men are coming aboard saying, hey, I can be a feminist because it's okay to be gay. And you go, what are you doing here? You don't belong in this movement. Or I heard a girl the other day saying, I need feminism because we still live in a culture where it's considered okay to cut off the top of a baby's penis.
Right.
And you go, that's a penis. That you don't have one of those. You can't be... Why are men coming aboard? And I find when I say things, like I recently said it's okay to hit a woman if she hits you 12 times. And I had all these male conservatives saying, that's disgusting. You should never hit a woman under any circumstances. And feminists were saying, 12? More like one. We're equal to men. So I find that that modern feminism is worse for women than traditional conservatism. Mm-hmm. And even there's a new anti-feminist woman named Karen Strawn.
I've met her.
She's like a 5 out of 10. Yeah, she's not that hot. But she was saying that... Before feminism began, they were considering, the president of the United States was considering making wife battery a capital offense. So traditionally, men have been more what's the word, delicate, or have considered women more sacred than feminists have. They're all about slut walks and have sex till you're 40 and work your ass off supporting a family. They're harder on women than women.
I want to ask you.
I mean, then men, sorry.
We have just a few moments left, but I want to ask you because I think that the pro-choice movement has become synonymous with the feminist movement. And there are so many men in this world today that are, you know, over the top pro-choice. What do you think? Is it because they personally are pro-choice or is it because of their own self-interest?
Free love is very convenient for single guys. Slut marches are very convenient for single guys. There's a lot for men in feminism. It's a great place to be because it means you get to have sex with whoever you want, and when she gets pregnant, she aborts it. About 50% of women are pro-life. And what's really interesting about abortion is we're getting towards gender-based abortions, as we've seen in China. That doesn't go well for women. Women are having abortions based on
gender.
They're
happening in Canada, too.
Women tend to lose on that.
They're happening in Canada, too.
So it's starting to become a genocide of unborn females. So you have free sex, genocide of females, and oppression of pro-life women. Abortion has nothing to do with feminism.
You know, you've sufficiently made me blush this interview, but that's all the time we have. Thank you for joining me.
You're an eight. Thank you for having me.